Praise the name of the Lord. Alright, today is the grand finale of our Trendy Trainers weekend. Praise God. And also, it's our BROADVIEW Sunday. So, I'm here, I have a lot of questions in my heart, and I'm going to be asking. And you people, the congregation, everyone seated, will be the one answering and telling us what the answers are to these questions. Very heavy on my heart, questions. So my job is very easy this morning, it's just to ask questions. We all are going to preach. Are we ready?
Yeah.
Are we ready?
Yeah.
I want us to say yes like soldiers. Are we ready?
Yeah.
Praise the name of the Lord. All right, our topic this morning is ambition. Okay, so at no point will pastor come up and say, okay, it's time for preaching again. No. So whatever you want to take down, please take it down now as people are contributing. And also to appreciate God for this opportunity and thank my Father in the Lord. Sir, God bless you and take you higher in the name of Jesus. All right, ambition. So the first topic, question is, what is ambition? What is ambition? Like we always do. What is ambition? There's a hand over there, please. Can we put it behind? What is ambition?
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Ambition is a strong desire to achieve something. Also, it is the determination to be successful. Praise the Lord.
Determination to be. Is ambition only a desire? Okay, I want a car. I desire a car. Is it only a desire? Praise the name of the Lord. A strong desire. Is it just a desire? Pastor, excuse me.
Praise the Lord. Ambition is a desire backed up with a drive towards a goal with visible actions that is in line with that goal. It's a desire with drive towards a goal, but it won't just be there. People, we even have this one is ambition with some visible actions towards that goal.
Praise the name of the Lord. So it is not just for us to sit on our bed and I want a car and we sleep 365 days in a year and we desire a car. But that's not ambition. Praise the name of the Lord. I want to ask a question. Some people say ambition is the face of greed. Ambition is the face of greed. Praise the name of the Lord. Is that true? Is that true? Ambition is the face of greed. It's the mask you wear when you want to be greedy. That's what they are saying. That once you wear that mask, you call it ambition. You are indirectly saying, I'm greedy. Praise God. Is ambition the face of greed? Praise God. I told you when we started, I have a lot of questions in my heart. If ambition is the face of greed, so why are people saying this one has no ambition? Is NFA, no future ambition? Is ambition the face of greed? If it is the face of greed, why are people accusing some other people that this one is NFA, no future ambition? Praise the name of the Lord. This house is full, bro. It's cool. I'm a Sunday school teacher. I will come and give you my microphone now.
Praise the Lord. Well, ambition is the face of greed. I'm just saying, from the village that we have come by, I don't know very much. But if actually people normally, if you say people say that, well, that should be negative ambition. Because we should be able to define positive and negative ambition. If you have ambition towards something noble, you can not be wrong trying to outdo others in a noble thing. You try to better other people's life, for example. You try to live holy. You try to do something noble. But when the ambition is towards whatever will come away, whoever will come away from me to attain this post, this position, to be elected, are we doing it without to be ritual? That one is now, it can now go under that definition in a negative ambition.
Praise the name of the Lord. Any other contribution?
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
actually can be a place of prayer if God is not involved. And I'm watching a film titled What If? You know, the lady married, that's newly married, you know, has this ambition to save life through her discovery. She discovered a drug, I don't know, an idea to save, you know, lives. But she needed money. We're talking of $80 million. So there was a woman, very rich, wealthy, say, okay, I will give you this money, but I will need to sleep with your husband. I give you 24 hours to think about it. And she needed that money. She spoke with the husband, they both agreed. And the husband slept with the woman. But after then, you know, the relationship started, you know, shaking. Praise the Lord. So ambition can be a face of greed if God is not involved, like our politicians. Praise the Lord. They are ready to kill their mother to get to that post. They are ready to kill their child or their wife, you know, to get there. So they are ready to do anything to get to, you know, attain that position. Praise the Lord. So that is in what you said, the face of greed. Praise the Lord.
Praise the name of the Lord. I want to ask another question. Add to that. You see, David at some point in his life was anointed to become king in Israel. Was David ambitious? Was David ambitious? I told you I have so many questions in my heart, and I will walk freely into the congregation to come and give somebody my microphone. If everybody continues to look at me like this, I'm a Sunday school teacher, don't forget. Was David ambitious? He was anointed at some point in his life to be king. Thereafter, was he ambitious? Okay, I'm coming for you. All right, there's someone.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, sir.
If you look at the story of David, you find out that he's a man of destiny. He wasn't too ambitious, but he was working hard. God chose him, and he worked hard to meet up with the prophecy that was in his life. Some of us have problem of being greedy with the prophecies that come to us. There is something that happens every Monday.
People go to church on Sunday, the pastors give prophecies. On Monday, people fall victim very easily. 419 people meet them. They tell you, your pastor said, you are going to do this, you are going to do this. They fall easily, very easily. On Mondays, you see that most of the things they do to people happen on Mondays. Because on Sunday, they go to church, they receive prophecies. And on Monday, any small thing you tell them, they fall victim. So it is negative ambition in that case. In David's case, he worked hard to meet up with God's prophecy on his life. We need to work hard when we receive prophecies. It's not just to go and follow whatever you hear or whatever you think that the easy way out. There's no easy way out to life. You have to work for it. It's not that when the pastor gives you a prophecy on Sunday, on Monday you come out, somebody tells you, I will change dollars for you, I will do this for you, you follow them. So most of the 419 people, they know that Monday is the target. When they come from church, that's the truth. From church on Monday, they target the people because they know that on Sunday they receive prophecies. And they are easy prayer to whatever they tell them on Monday.
Praise the name of the Lord. Thank you, sir. Now I want to ask another question. He said we should walk out towards our goal. Jacob and Esau. The prophecy came. Jacob Avendo, Esau Abaite. And he walked out and he got his brother's birthright. Was that a good ambition or not? Next turn, I'll take microphone.
I want to say something on the last question that you asked, not this one, about David. David had many opportunities to kill Saul, but he didn't do so. He said that he will not lay his hand upon a man anointed by God. So he has an ambition, but he traded to his fear. He still has the fear of God.
He traded
his fear. He has a fear of God in him. He would have killed him. If he's in this present world, some people will say, yeah, this is the right opportunity for us to get rid of him so that his ambitions to become the king will materialize. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. So I want to answer the question.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I think Jacob's ambition was, you know, not good, not, it was fraudulent. Praise the Lord. But he stole the brother's birthright. And that was why God changed his name from Jacob to Israel. Praise the Lord. So I think that one was bad.
Praise the name of the Lord. If that is bad, how should Jacob have acted? How should he have acted in that circumstance to actualize the prophecy of God without the way he went about it? What should he have done? There's a hand behind. There's a hand behind. Someone is raising up his hand behind. Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Jacob has been destined to be the head because God has always told him that Jacob I love, Esau I hated. If Jacob has never duped, he was the first foreigner in the Bible has ever recorded. And yes, and he is a supplanter. When they mean supplanter is still a foreigner. It's still another word for foreigner. He's a dubious person, but destiny can never change. What God has said will always come to pass. He never walked like his grandfather Abraham. He never took the ideas of Isaac. He goes about the ideas of the woman, of his mother. So even though he never cheated on his brother, he never duped his brother, what God has said would have come even easier and faster. And the brother himself went on his own and came back. Even at that time, Jacob has already settled. His brother has already settled at least 7 times above Jacob. So I believe as only Jacob was not even a supplanter, God would have used him, but God needed a criminal for that.
So that was my opinion. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
With our souls. Well, that act of Jacob was a negative one. The fact that God has already told, just like our brother just said, even if God prophesied, and as Sister Lady said, that to tread cautiously, we cannot be going outside of the confine of God's commandment. And because God has said can also change his mind. He changed his mind concerning Ephraim in Isaiah chapter 4, I think 17. Ephraim was supposed to be better and greater than Manasseh. Ephraim, the younger brother, and he was blessed above. But what God now saying in Isaiah chapter 4, he said that, Ephraim has joined himself to idol, let him alone. So one thing about God, about this thing about God has said, God could say, but God also can change his mind. You are a human being, you can change your mind. God can change his mind. And he has created you in his image. If you can change your mind, he too can change his mind. Concerning Jacob, he did that the wrong way and he paid for it. Then he now took time to not go back. That's the part of repentance. You know, you can, because of this drive, it has been said that I will be greater than my brother. Okay, this is the opportunity. Just like David did not take that opportunity too at that time. And in God's time, God placed him there. He took that, and if you really look straight the life of Jacob, he suffered. The way the children lied, the way the father-in-law, he brought many things, many adverts that ought not to have been. Well, he now got to a time, he now went the right way. He wrestled with God. This thing that God has said, it took prayer that God went to bring it to pass. And the Bible said that day he prevailed. And God said, you have been blessed. It was not the blessing that he took that took him to all the things that he got. It was the blessing he got that day, the right one. After going wrong, they now said, no, even with all these things that have gone wrong, it has not really profited me. I've suffered so many things. I now cut off from his family. He said, just let me go. He rest with God. And God said, what's your name? And changed his name. And the Bible said that, and then God blessed him. It was not the father's blessing that made him. It was that blessing he got that life that made him.
Let's put hands together for Jesus. Not because he's pastor, but because he said the right. Let's put hands together for Jesus again. God bless you, sir. All right, let's see Matthew 20:26-28. Some people went to Jesus. They said, when we get there, we want to be on your right and on your left. And some other people, other disciples got to know about it. And they were very angry. How can you do that? Praise the name of the Lord. So 20:26. And Jesus responded to them and said, but it shall not be so among you. In the world, people scheme and do all those things to get there. But Jesus is saying, it shall not be so among you. But whosoever will be great among you, let him be your minister. How do I go about it? Jesus is telling us, 27. And whosoever will be chief among you, let him be your servant. 28. Even as the Son of Man, come not to be ministered unto, but to minister, and to give his life for a ransom. Praise the name of the Lord. Service, that's what he's saying. God will help us in Jesus' name. Can ambition be misguided? Misguided ambition. I remember Paul. Let's answer the question. Let me not tell you what I remember. Can ambition be misguided? Can it be misguided? Running in the negative direction, just like Pastor told us yesterday. But they are still running. Can ambition be misguided? You are running, but in the name
of the Lord.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Ambition can be misguided. You know, ambition is like conception. And sometimes conception may not get onto the point of delivery if the pregnancy is not well handled. It's not a big thing that just happened. Some of them, maybe in the midwives, the whoever that many things that must go to play in the bringing forth of the baby outside of the one that is even carrying the baby. You know, so it can be misguided. The environment a person is can do that. The background the person has come from can do that, and also the influences of the people around, what the people talking to the person. You are too slow, let me take you to somebody. You still towards a particular goal, just making it towards. So I think it can be misguided by some factors. It could even be more than these few factors that I've just said.
Praise the name of the Lord. Ambition. Somebody is raising up his hand behind. Someone is raising up his hand behind. Please, let's get to him quickly. Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise the Lord. I just want to help Pastor to make some conclusion. He has really said everything from. Let us use some Bible character to look at this. Ambition in the case of what are they calling it? This man that likes following Samson.
Yes.
That likes following the lion. So Samson's ambition was to be a hero, was to help Israel to fight. But when they came through, everybody knew in Israel, even the priest, they anointed him when he was born, they all said their savior he was here. But when time came, Samson was left doing something else, and nobody could ever tell him what he was doing, because the fear of everybody was, they were all afraid of Samson. So Samson was one character in the Bible that had a very, very good ambition, but due to one thing or the other, which due to one factor, one of the factors which Pastor has called made him to me.
Praise God.
To me, so it was nice.
Thank you, sir. How about Paul? Paul was persecuting the church. He had ambition. He was zealous. How about the children of Israel? The Bible says concerning them, they have the zeal, but not according to knowledge. So sometimes, maybe this is how God has planned your life, and you are going in this direction. I think we also need to take a pause and think about our lives. Praise the name of the Lord. And also, realign our ambition with God has planned for us. God will help us in the name of Jesus. God will help us in the name of Jesus. I remember in the Bible, Luke chapter 12, it talks about the rich fool. He had a big barn. He said, I'll break this down. I'll build another one. And I'll tell my soul, eat and be merry. Praise the name of the Lord. And the Bible says, ye fool, today your soul will be taken, requested of you. And the Bible says, he was rich, he was not rich unto God. Are you seeing yourself in that man? Are you seeing yourself in that man? Praise the name of the Lord. And lastly, I'll ask a question. What should be our ultimate ambition? Ultimate, as children of God. Ultimate ambition, before I go ahead. Someone is raising his hand over there. Two people already. Ultimate ambition.
Praise the Lord, Chair. Our ultimate ambition as a Christian is to make heaven. Enter the fact we have other things in life, like money and the rest. But the goal is to make heaven.
She has added something to it. We will make money, or we will live well, or we will make heaven. Pray to the Lord. All right, sir.
As my sister said, God made her vision to make heaven. Let the other thing take on it. Added to it is peace of mind. If there is no peace of mind, our vision is useless.
Praise the name of the Lord. Is that your ambition today? It's a question. And I'm not asking us to answer it. Is that your ambition today? Is your ambition to make heaven? Or all that you are doing is you are already setting the line. No, that person is not here in Jesus' name to go into hell. You see, somebody said something sometimes ago that hell has no parolees. When you say someone is on parole, that means he's allowed to go, he gets into prison, he's allowed to go, but his movement is restricted, they monitor him. But once you are him forever. It does not have exit. Hell does not have exit. It is only enter. He knows. You know, it doesn't know come out. Praise the name of the Lord. Are you, is everything you are doing taking you to heaven or hell? It is a decision we have to make, and it is something we have to think about. Praise the name of the Lord. Let's bow down our heads as we think for a few minutes. Let's think for a few minutes. And let's tell God, is there any way or anyhow that I've been behaving that is taking me towards hell? Lord, give me a change of heart. Change my direction. Just as you met with Paul on the way to Damascus, and he changed his name from Saul to Paul. Lord, give me a change of heart in the name of Jesus. Father, help me that everything I do going forward, whether in the circular, whether in the house of God, will take me to heaven. I will start living in consciousness of you from now on in the name of Jesus. Let's tell it to God. Lord, help me. Let me not by my own action take myself to hell. I know that you have plans for me. Your plans towards me are good to take me to an expected end. Lord, let me not by my own actions, by the things I do or do not do, take myself to hell. Lord, help me. Help me, Lord.